It's a beautiful spring day here in San Francisco, a perfect time to talk about suicide, really. Hey everyone, Laci Green here for D News. Did you know that suicides peak in the spring? It's a stable trend that's been tracked since the 1820s and in dozens of countries around the world. The most suicidal month is May, when suicides spike by up to 50%. I would have guessed it would have been in the winter months, but nope. The winter months actually have the lowest suicide rates. And as for those affected, suicide is the most common amongst those over 65, but for the 15 to 24 age group, suicide is the third leading cause of death. Now, while women are more likely to have suicidal thoughts, men are more likely to complete a suicide and make up about 80% of cases. This is attributed to the fact that men are more likely to use unforgivable means like firearms, whereas women are more likely to overdose or poison themselves. Now, there are a lot of big questions to untangle the suicide web in order to effectively prevent them, and one of them is, why spring? Why suicides around the world peak in the spring is actually one of the most studied questions in psychiatry, which makes it even stranger that scientists still don't have any hard answers. One of the original theories when this was first discovered in the 1800s is that spring brings more sun, and with the sun, more feel-good neurotransmitters like serotonin provide us with more energy. But in a depression sufferer, that energy manifests not with more socializing and time outdoors, but as inward aggression and self-harm. Spring sun may also provide a boost of energy required to successfully execute a suicide plan. Now, while this is an old theory, it's one that's still around and it's highly regarded by scientists. In fact, the serotonin bit was a more recent development. Another leading theory comes down to the relationship between suicide and inflammation. What we've already known for a while is that there is a strong link between depression and inflammation. Inflammatory diseases heighten depression risk more so than other diseases do. There are a couple of reasons why inflammation might be higher in the spring. People tend to get sick more in the winter, which I did another D News on why if you're interested, and there may be more residual inflammation from those late winter infections. Another reason is, of course, allergies. Allergies drive an inflammatory response. A study at the University of Maryland actually found a positive link between high tree pollen counts with high seasonal suicide rates. This has also been repeated by other scientists. Now, it's also been found that those who work in agriculture have even more exaggerated suicide rates in the spring. It may very well be in the trees, peeps. I seem to recall an M. Night Shyamalan movie about something like that. I think it was called The Happening. Kind of weird. Maybe he was onto something. Thanks for joining me for D News, everyone. Stay safe and healthy. I dropped some stuff down below in the description for anyone out there who may be having a rough time themselves this spring. Nobody should have to go it alone, and sometimes reaching out for help is the bravest thing that you can do to take care of yourself. I'll see you folks next time. Bye-bye.